We're now back in open session, we'll continue discussion.
Good, okay.
And we are talking, about the motion to.
Yes, appoint. Exactly, that's exactly what we're talking about, so no problem. So, here's our problem. Our other option, of course, is Mr. Hubbard, and I'm not sure if it's a problem that Mr. Hubbard has with women in general, with strong women, with intelligent women. I'm not sure what it is, but he's not even a little bit capable of being respectful. This man threatens me on a regular basis. He intimidates other people, he shouts people down. He has less control over himself than any other person on this Board of Education. While people have been distressed with me for saying things, I have never stood up and screamed at people, nevertheless screamed for recess. I have never acted like a complete idiot the way Mr. Hubbard does, and I do not want that as representation of our Board of Education. This man, his only purpose lately is to go ahead and control other people. I'm sorry, Mr. Hubbard, you're never going to control me. And I don't care if it's because I'm smarter than you, because I am more grounded than you, or because I'm not just going to go ahead and snuggle up with administration to just go ahead and go along and get along. I don't know what it is that you want, if you want your trip to China, or you get your little perks that I've heard about, or what it is, Mr. Hubbard, but I'll tell you what, the name can't be. It'll be a cold day when you think that you're going to go ahead and work with me. Because if you say you are, you're as big of a liar as there ever was.
Nancy. So, when we took recess, I heard someone say that, quote, well, someone needs to control her. So,
who's going to control
stop, please. Great. Whoever ends up being our board president needs to realize that as elected officials, we all have a right to our opinion, we all have a right to our voice. But the issue is not to control people. I know that a lot of people think that Mrs. Hilton and I always agree, and we do not always agree on everything. But I think that you don't see the two of us butting heads at the board table or having heated discussions, because I do choose to communicate with people, so whoever ends up being our board president needs to be a leader and be able to communicate with people. So whether it's Donna or myself, whoever it is, we need to start working together as a board and respecting people's opinions and working together isn't about controlling each other. It's about listening to each other and respecting people's opinions and having honest and open communication. I think Mrs. Hilton and I don't have disagreements because we do communicate with each other even though we don't always agree. So I don't think it's about controlling anyone, and whoever our next board president is needs to figure that out.
Thank you.
I think we're screwed.
I have a question. I understand, Mr. Huber, you have a post of the MASB, that you also have vice chair of SEMGOV. And MISD, you're on that board. You're the chair of the foundation, and you're on the parent advisory board. That's a lot of time spent.
That's all correct.
My concern is, this position takes a lot of time. And to do it well, it's like a full-time job, as far as I'm concerned.
Well, we are talking, first of all, we can continue on, but we're talking about the nomination right now.
Linda, stop trying to stifle conversation.
I'm not trying to stifle conversation. Continue on, then, Mrs. Sylvia.
I thought it was that we were talking about asking questions of the candidates. This is how we.
Okay, all right, guys. All right, then continue.
So, my concern is those are very detailed, difficult, and this position, having chaired committees and chaired organizations, is a full time job. And I'm concerned of being able to allow time and meet all the needs of all of these organizations respectful way, and this is a concern of mine, because this is a full-time job. Being a board member is three-quarter full job. So that's just my concern.
I have a comment I'd like to make too. I think that, you know, obviously, state organizations, our county has shown faith in Don. We've never been as well informed when it comes to legislation as Don reports at the table. No one has worked harder, I think, to keep you current on what's happening in the state at any level. And Amy, you know, I do see, and I've got multiple positions, what's happened, I think those positions complement one another. It makes our president sort of very aware of what's going on at all levels. And it's not really time away from the board, it's really maximizing his time for the board. So I felt like, I think Don is, you know, when he came on board, wasn't that way, you know, but he's got more and more involved, and he's got the, you know, the county and state approval. So I feel honored, really, that someone this caliber would step up and be one of the president of the Officers School Board.
Did you say this caliber?
Yes, ma'am, I said that.
All of a sudden, you want to be respectful of me? Yes, ma'am? Are you kidding? I'm sorry. This caliber of a chauvinist, I have no desire to have representing this Board of Education. This caliber of threatening behavior, this caliber of throwing fits, this caliber of outbursts, dear Lord, have you not been here? Because this caliber of maniacal behavior, dear Lord, I do not want to represent our Board of Education. I think there is no worse representation. I mean, everybody knows my grief with Linda because I don't feel that she is effective in what she does. But Don actually obstructs.
Ms. Harberger just asked that her name be withdrawn.
Would Don believe that?
Do you agree?
Yes.
Mrs. Harberger's name is withdrawn. Her second nomination was Don Hubler. A motion would be in order to elect Don Hubler as president of the Board of Education for the 15-16 school year.
So moved.
I'll support it.
A motion has been made by Mrs. Ross, supported by Mr. Hoover, that we nominate Don Hubler to be elected to the office of president of the Board of Education for the 15-16 school year. Like a roll call, please.
I'd like this kind of end for discussion, please.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's all right.
Discussion.
I'll only take a minute. There's a question about time. I'm retired, retired for a number of years now. I do put in a lot of time for a number of different organizations, and I think it gives me some unique perspective on both local, state, and national topics of discussion, both the legislative and legal. I take the commitment very seriously. I appreciate Pam's comment of working together. Because I personally, the board got a tremendous respect for Lynn Platcher's work as president and what she's done. Anybody in this room or anybody watching can see how challenging this could be. And the reason for doing this is for kids. It's not about, and that's the sad thing in all this. We don't talk much about what's best for our district, what's for our kids, what's the opportunity, what are the challenges, what we should be doing. And it's unfortunate because we're distracted by vehement accusations. We have a wonderful district. We have wonderful students. Our scores are good. Our students are achieving very high standards. Our graduation rate is exceptional, one of the highest in the state. And those are things much attributed to a great district. So this is about the board. This, you know, the district isn't for the board. possibly can help facilitate, you know, the opportunity for a tree.
Any other discussion on the motion?
Don, everything you've said is not true, and I am disgusted. It's not about kids. It's about covering our superintendent, who is ineffective, that you continually want to keep her there.
Any other comments?
I'd just like to apologize to the community for the session.
Thank you. I as well.
I apologize that Don has been so nasty.
Can we have a roll call on this motion?
I just asked for a roll call.
Okay. Mr. Roscoe, yes. Mr. Hoover?
Hoover, yes.
Mrs. Stilton?
No.
Mr. Hoover?
Yes.
Mrs. Servio?
No.
Mrs. Hornberger?
Yes.
Mrs. McClatchy?
Yes.
Five yeses.
Mr. Don Hoover has been elected to the office of President of the Board of Education for the 15-16 school year. Congratulations.
So moved.
Sharon Ross? excuse me, is there discussion on the motion? Hearing none, a roll call vote, please.
Mrs. Ross votes yes. Mr. Hoover?
Yes.
We're having a hard time sharing, telling the difference between Hoover and Hoopla.
Okay, sorry. I have a try harder. Mrs. Farmer?
Who made the motion? Are you going in order?
Yeah.
No.
Mrs. Servio?
No.
Mrs. Hilton?
No.
Mr. Hoover? I mean, Mrs. McLeod, sorry.
Yes.
And Mr. Hoover?
Yes.
Four yes votes.
We have four yes votes for Lynn McCantrell for the office of vice president, which constitutes the majority of the board. Would there be a motion for a unanimous decision to nominate Linda McLatcher for vice president?
I'll make a motion.
It's a motion by Ken Hoover to nominate.
We don't have to.
Is there a support for the motion for a unanimous vote?
You can't make a motion as the president.
Yeah.
No, I didn't make it.
No,
but I asked her. I asked if there was a motion. Ken Hoover made the motion. Is there support for that motion?
Sure, why not?
Okay, we have a motion for a unanimous support for Linda McMaster as vice president. Is there any discussion on
this? Yes, there is. Well, Linda has served under our new superintendent in really tough times. And until you raise that in that position, you can understand, what it is, what you have to go through. I personally think I'm very proud of the way she's conducted herself at the table. And so many may not realize that Linda served on previous boards, and she has served as president of previous boards. And I want to thank her for those 2 years that have been the previous times that she was on the board. And if you look back at all the people who served with Linda, they all say the same thing, because I know many of them personally. So I think we'd be a class act tomorrow. We voted. She is our vice president, but I think the healing that we need to do in this district, these are the kind of things the board eventually. I mean, I've been the only negative vote at times and the odd man out. But it's part of being a school board member is realizing when the vote is taken, we move on, and give each other our support, and we do the best for our district. So I think this is the right thing to do. And since she is already vice president, I highly think this is the appropriate thing to
do.
The reason I disagree with that is this board needs a complexion change, a changing complexion of the officers.
See, I don't agree.
You can disagree with me, and I can disagree with you. That's politics.
That's exactly right.
But I really think sometimes new infusion of different ideas and new blood can help heal a board or help it move forward. It's my statement.
Well, the board wasn't broken when Glenn was on board previously.
I never said it was broken. I said it can lead to new ideas.
According to Ken, the board has only been broken for a couple of years, as long as actually Sharon and I have been here. And this board is broken because we have four board members with their head in the sand, and we are getting a whole other year of exactly the same. And I don't think that's any way to making it better. I think that's any way to healing, Ken. And I don't know why you think that somehow just putting another gauze on top of a bleeding wound is going to change it. It's not. Because we still have disrespectful, we still have head in the sand, we still have protect dishonesty. We haven't.
I'm going to make a comment one more time. I am one of seven board members. My head is not in the sand. I do my homework. I do a lot of stuff on the side that you're not even aware of. And I am really getting tired of you lumping me in with people who are voting against what you want and saying that I don't know what I'm doing. So I think it'd be nice if you'd stop doing that, please.
Ms. Ross.
You've been singled out. That would be your issue.
I didn't say singled out, I said I'm one of seven board members and you like to lump a certain four of us together all the time. Especially when we're not agreeing with you, and I think we need to get to the place, once again, try and stay there, where we can talk, we can disagree, we can even not like each other. But we work on still talking, so don't start. Thank you so much. Well, we work together as a group, we put our garbage aside, we worked for the betterment of this district, for our employees, for our students, and for our community. And as a parting comment on this, I think that maybe a mirror might be in order for someone that's not on the board.
See, but that's the issue.
I'm not talking to mirror in general, I'm talking to everybody.
That's the issue in general.
Everybody.
You may not agree with Mrs. Hilton's opinion, but she's allowed to have it. And she shouldn't be allowed to have it without someone else stepping in and then making their comments about how she shouldn't do X, Y, and Z.
No, Mary can say what she wants to say, and Mary does say what she wants to say. What I'm saying is that Mary can't speak for all of us, and she collectively does very frequently, to the point where it's becoming repeated as though it's truth, and I want to make sure we understand that's not
true. I think we all understand that. But then when someone makes comments about there needs to be a mirror, I mean, it's no better than what you think is already happening.
No, this board needs to take a good look at itself.
The chair hearing a lot of discussion, would you consider withdrawing your motion? We have a vote.